Okay guys, I'm going to show you how to clean your sponge filter in your baby clownfish grow out tank. I have two sponge filters in there because the clowns, obviously, they're a lot bigger now. I haven't posted a video in a while, just due to the fact I've been real busy and I just been enjoying them growing. This should be at least 5 months old now, this batch of clowns that I have in here. So I do have a couple runts in there, so they're small, but this video right now is to mainly show you how to clean the sponge filters, and then I'm going to post another video here today or tomorrow on how to actually clean the tank, because obviously you can see there's salt buildup, salt creeping around the tank, the glass looks dirty, the bottom of the tank is dirty, the heater is kind of filthy, but mostly the food pellets I've been feeding them is the Formula One pellets from Ocean Nutrition. They're big enough to eat this now, but when I first started them off, there's the I think they're pronounced Opium larvae and grow out feed. There's a kit on a site that I'm going to probably try to put in a link, so if you guys are trying to do this, you guys could go ahead and pick some up yourself. But right now they're on the C1 and C2 because there's some small ones in there and some bigger ones, so that's what I feed them also. But I'm trying to cut down on the Formula One pellets, because when I pull this filter out, I'm going to show you that on the sponge filter itself, it's got a lot of red built up inside here. And that's pretty much due to all the food and the waste that's coming off of it. But the clownfish babies are pretty big right now, so they're at the point where the food is getting eaten, but there's so much waste coming from the fish that the sponge filters are having a hard time trying to clean it. This is meant for a 10-gallon. I also have a 5-gallon in here as well. It's a lot smaller. But they're both kind of filthy right now, and the water's kind of cloudy, and I'm going to do a video on how to obviously show you how to clean one of these. I'm going to go ahead and take it over to the bathroom right now. Let me just go ahead and kind of drain that a little bit. Unplug this, turn off that. Now, sometimes if you keep these lines on here for a while, they'll kind of get stuck. There's one. This one is kind of fairly new. There we go. Alright. So now we got that off, detached. We'll come over to the bathroom. Alright, I like to leave the hot water running. I'm going to show you on the bigger one, because the bigger one is the one I've been mainly doing. So what you want to do first is take this little clear piece off. You can slide it all the way off the hose, the airline hose. Just kind of rinse it out. I'm going to get in there, kind of clean it. It's going to be slimy. Kind of run your finger inside the tube and get all the nastiness out. Let that dry. Now this comes off in a couple pieces. The bottom piece, kind of just wiggle it back and forth, it'll pop right off. Clean the base of it because it's got all that slime coat on there. Just kind of like rub your hand on it. Or if you have a toothbrush, it'll work fine too. Let that sit there and dry off. Now this has two spots. You got the bottom of it and you got the top of it. You pretty much grab on it, just kind of pull apart on the top where the airline tube is. That's the part that actually detaches. The other part slides out of the sponge. There's one whole piece. So this on the inside does get dirty. So try to get in there as best as you can. This is where toothbrush that you wouldn't brush your teeth with would work really good.
I wouldn't say use your toothbrush and then wake up in the morning and brush your teeth with that same brush. It's kind of gross. So, I'm going to go ahead and scrub everything that's in there. I want to try to get on the base of the actual stem that's in there. Just like that. Let that dry off next. This piece kind of gets filthy around the edge. And the inside too. Get your toothbrush, kind of go ahead and scrub. Try to clean the line too. The line gets kind of slimy and nasty from sitting in the salt water. Let that hang out there. Now a sponge filter. This is what's really dirty. You can kind of see right there, it's all red and nasty. It's from all the fish food and the poop from the fish themselves. When you squeeze it, you can kind of see it in the water. I'll change a little bit of the color of it. What you want to do is kind of just get as much water as you possibly can soaked up into the sponge. You can see the coloration in the water when it's hitting the sink, and I can go ahead and press the water out. It's a little bit dirty there, not too bad. But it's getting to the point where I'm going to have to move the babies into a tank with an actual filter. The sponge filter, I mean, it's doing a good job, but I'm going to have to be cleaning the sponge filter every 3 days because the baby's already pretty much almost at the full size. You go ahead and sell them. But I don't think I'm going to sell mine because this is my first batch that I've ever had actually stay alive. I'm kind of excited and happy, and all the success that I have, I just want to keep them now. But I don't know what tank I'm going to put them in. It's my problem. This is what you want to do though. You want to go ahead and run it through the hot water, squeeze it out, try to get in between, kind of brush whatever food's in there, debris or waste. You want to keep doing this a couple times until the water that comes out of the sponge is kind of clear. Because there is a lot of stuff still trapped deep inside the sponge. You can kind of see around this base right here, you'll still see it.